In this video, you will learn everything you need to know about using Ollama, from basic setup to downloading and running open source models to more advanced topics. As an added bonus, we will also install Open WebUI, which is a beautiful user interface for interacting with your models. And yes, this also includes RAG, so you can upload and chat with your own documents. First, let's download and install Ollama. Go to ollama.com, then click on Download, then select your operating system, and click on Download. Then execute the file that you just downloaded, and from this pop-up, click on Install, and Ollama will now be installed on your machine. You can start Ollama in one of two ways. The first option is to run the Ollama desktop app. You should then see the Ollama icon in your system tray. The second option is to open your command prompt or terminal, and then in the terminal, run Ollama serve. But because I'm already running Ollama, I do receive this message, which we can simply ignore. We can verify that Ollama is running by entering Ollama in the terminal, and you should see a list of all possible commands if Ollama is working correctly. Now let's get familiar with some of the most common commands that you will use with Ollama. First, we can view all the available models by entering Ollama list. And at the moment, we don't have any models installed. So let's have a look at how we can download our first model. Back on the Ollama website, let's click on Models. Here we can search for models or sort by featured models or the most popular models or the newest models. We can see the details of a model by clicking on its name. And from this page, we can see that there are two versions of this model available, the 9 billion parameter model and a 27 billion parameter model. The hardware requirements for running these models will greatly depend on which size model you download. For most of us, the smaller models like 8 billion or 9 billion will be perfectly fine, whereas the larger models are typically meant for enterprise-grade hardware. From this drop-down, we can select the model that we are interested in. Let's simply stay on the 9 billion parameter model. Scrolling down, we can see some additional information about the model, like its license, and some other information. And we can see the instructions for downloading and running the model on the right-hand side over here. And if we had to change this model, you will also see that this command changes on the right-hand side. But let's simply swap back to the 9 billion parameter model. In order to download and run this model, you can simply copy this command and paste it into the command prompt. This will both download and immediately run this model. But instead, I just want to show you how you can download this model without running it. Let's copy the name of this model, and then in our command prompt, let's enter Ollama pool and then the model name. And let's run this to start the download. Our model was now successfully downloaded. Now this is optional, but I am going to download two additional models. And this will come into play later on in the video, but you do not have to follow this step as well. So I'm going to download the Gemma 2 billion parameter model, as well as a super impressive Ollama 3 model. So now let's run Ollama list again, and this time we will see the models that we just downloaded. In your case, it might only be one model. To view the details of any specific model, we can run the command Ollama show followed by the model name. Take note that it's not necessary to enter latest as well. Running this will show you the base model that was used for this model, the amount of parameters, the context size, and some other important information. We can also remove a model by running Ollama RM followed by the model name, and done. If I run Ollama list again, you will notice that Gemma is now gone. Now let's move on to the fun stuff. We can run our model by typing Ollama run followed by the model name. Let's use the Gemma 2 model. Now let's test this out by sending a message like, hello there. And we do get our response back from the model. Excellent. Now let's enter something like, write the lyrics to a song about automating my life using AI. And our model is hard at work writing our song for us. Great stuff. It's important to note that our conversation history is being stored for this session. For example, if I say something like, my name is Leon, I can then ask our model, what is my name? And the model will be able to recall information from our conversation history. Now let's have a look at a few special commands that we can run within this chat window. Let's have a look at the set command. We can access the set command by entering /set. This will show you a whole bunch of attributes that you can set about the session. For this video, let's have a look at the parameters command as well as the system command. We won't have a look at all of these, but I do want to show you a very important parameter. So let's enter set parameters. Actually, it should be set parameter. And within parameter, we have this temperature value that we can set. Temperature is a value between 0 and 1. 1 means that the model will be completely creative, where 0 means that it will be factual and stick to the system prompt. So for something like a chatbot, we might want to set the temperature to something like 0.7. Or if you want a chatbot that is factual, for instance, a math tutor, then set the temperature to a low value like 0 or maybe 0.2. I'm going to set the temperature to 0.7. Now let's set one more value, and that is the system message. We can use the system message to give a personality or role to our model, or give the model very specific instructions on how to respond. For instance, let's call set system and in quotes, something like, you are a pirate, your name is John. Let's set this. We can also display these values by entering /show. Here we can show information about the model that we're currently using, the model's license, the model file, which we will have a look at later on in this video, the parameters, the system message, etc. For example, let's show the parameters. And here we can see that the temperature was set to 0.7. Let's also show the system message, which we set to you are a pirate, your name is John. Great. We can also save these changes as a brand new model. We can do that by entering /save and the name of our new model, which I will call John the Pirate. And let's press enter. And this has now saved our changes as a brand new model. To exit the chat, we can simply enter /bye. And now we're back in the terminal. So now, if we enter Ollama list, we can actually see the model that we just created. So, if we ever wanted to continue our conversation, we can enter Ollama, run, John the Pirate, and let's press enter. And now we can see the conversation history, and if we send our model a message, like, who are you? Our model will respond like a pirate, and it knows that its name is John. How cool is that? I do want to show you one more way in which you can create your very own models. Open up a folder on your machine, and then create a new file. It really doesn't matter how you create this file, so feel free to use any text editor that you want. I'll simply use VS Code. Then within this folder, create a new file and give it the name of the character that you want to create, like Mario, as an example. First, we need to start by telling Ollama which model we want to use as the base model. Then, we can set any of the parameters, just like we did in the command prompt, by first entering parameter, by the name of the parameter that we want to change, followed by the value that we want to set, like 0.7. Then we can also set the system message, which we need to set within 3 of these double quotes, like so. Then we can enter something like, you are Mario from Super Mario Bros. Answer as Mario. Let's go ahead and save this file, and I'm actually going to close the text editor. Now within this folder, we can simply open the command prompt by either right-clicking on this folder and clicking on open in terminal, or in the address bar, enter cmd. So now that we have the command prompt open in the same folder as this file, we can create our model by running Ollama create, followed by the name that we want to give this model, which I'll call Mario. Then enter -f, followed by period, /, and the name of our model file, which we called Mario. That is this file over here. Now let's press enter. Let's confirm that our model was created by running Ollama list, and indeed we can see that Mario was created. Let's also view the details of this model by running Ollama show Mario. And for this model, we can see that the Gemma2 model was used as the base model, and then other information like the temperature as well as our system message. Let's also run this model by entering Ollama run Mario. And let's send something like, who are you? And that sounds like Mario to me. We still have a lot to cover, but first, if you're finding this video useful, then please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Also, let me know down in the comments which open source models you prefer and why. Now, let's move on. So far, we've only interacted with our models in the terminal, which might be perfect for most use cases, but I'm sure that you would prefer to use a way more attractive UI than this. And we will have a look at installing the WebUI in a minute. This specific topic might be slightly more technical, but bear with me. This is an important topic for any developers watching this who might be interested in calling the Ollama models from their own applications. Ollama provides several API endpoints that you can use to create messages, create models, and pretty much everything else. I'm not going to cover all of these APIs in this video, as I do want to move on to setting up the WebUI, but I will leave a link in the description of this video to this GitHub repo. Let's simply have a look at creating a completion using this API endpoint. To demonstrate this, I'll simply call the endpoint from Postman by changing the method to post and then enter the following URL. This is assuming that your instance of Ollama is running on port 11434. Let's switch over to body and let's have a look at the JSON structure that we need to pass in. Within the body, let's enter the model name as Gemma2 and the prompt as why is the sky blue. Let's run this and you will notice that the response is coming through as chunks. And this is because the response is streaming back to us. We can disable streaming by adding another property called stream, which we can set to false. Now, when we run this again, we will receive the response in a single structure. Now, let's move on to installing the WebUI for Ollama. For this, we will install OpenWebUI, which was previously called Ollama WebUI. Thankfully, this is very simple. There really is only one dependency. You need to have Docker installed on your machine. To install Docker, go to docker.com. Then under products, go to Docker Desktop. Then go to download and download Docker for your operating system. And finally, execute the installer. After installation is completed, you should be able to find Docker Desktop on your machine. After installing Docker, you should be able to start the Docker Desktop and you will be presented with a screen similar to this. And that means that Docker is up and running. So all we have to do then is run a command that we can find on the Open WebUI page by scrolling down to the installation section. So here we've already installed Docker, and now we simply want to copy this command over here. Then we can open the command prompt or terminal and paste in the command that we just copied. Let's press enter. Now, if I switch back to Docker Desktop, I can see that OpenWebUI was added and it's currently running on this port. And if I open this, I will be presented with the sign in screen. Let's click on sign up, then enter your name. I'll also enter my email and a password. Let's create this account. And now we can actually start chatting to our models. We can select from all the available models by clicking on this dropdown. And here we can see Gemma2, Llama3, as well as our custom models. After selecting the model, we can actually start chatting to it, like hello, and this seems to be working. We can also chat to documents by uploading files. So I can click on more, upload files, and I'll simply upload this Tesla financial statement. And then I can ask questions like, what was the revenue for 2023? And the model will use RAG to answer questions from this document. If you would like to see how I used Ollama in building an advanced AI application in combination with Flowwise, then check out this video over here.